What series of startling events could come to a climax in a scene like this?
Filmed in a way you have never seen before, and as no one else would dare attempt, but the screen's master of suspense, the producer-director who shocked the world.
The Detroit News said it's the best crime play in years.
Good evening. I was just about to send greetings to an old friend. I'm sure modern civilized methods of homicide are much more efficient, but I don't care for them. I abhor violence. That is why on this program we use stabbings, shooting, and garrotings only when they are absolutely essential to the plot or when the whim strikes us.
Alfred Joseph Hitchcock was born on August the 13th, 1899, in the private quarters above his father's grocery store at 517 Leytonstone High Road in East London. The Hitchcock store had been established 3 years earlier and quickly secured a reputation as one of the area's foremost suppliers of fresh fruit, potatoes, and poultry. Leytonstone at that time was enjoying unprecedented growth and affluence. Based around an ancient pathway dating back to pre-Roman times, the area had once been a minor rural settlement characterised by vast open spaces and narrow streams. The neighbourhood had burst into life following the expansion of the steam railway from central London. And by the late 19th century, it was commonly referred to as England's fastest growing town, with high quality family homes emerging from the green fields at a rate of several hundred each year. And many boasting such highly desirable features as bay windows and front gardens. The area's population grew quickly and led to an influx of traders and shopkeepers, ready to do business with a rapidly developing new community.
We're in the money, we're in the money. We've got a lot of what it takes to get along. We're in the money, the sky's a sunny. Old man depression, you are through, you've done us wrong. We never see a headline by the bread line today. And when we see the landlord, we can look that guy right in the eye. We're in the money, come on my honey. Let's spend it, send it, lend it, rolling along.
Please endeavour to restrain yourselves. I don't want you to miss our story.
Young Alfie Hitchcock would grow up amidst the lively bustle of a successful family enterprise, encountering a constant flow of new faces in an area brimming with activity and optimism. He was, nonetheless, a quiet and reserved boy who lived in the shadow of his elder brother William and sister Nellie, who were both old enough to play an active role in the family business. His parents worked long and exhausting hours to make their shop a success, rewarding themselves with regular trips to the glamorous West End, where they would indulge their love of London's theatre land and dine out at the best restaurants they could afford. The family were also regular visitors to the Green Man, a local public house dating from the 17th century and, according to local legend, once a haunt of the famous highwayman Dick Turpin. In such a busy and lively household, their youngest child was inevitably sometimes left to fend for himself, and he would develop a keen sense of isolation, bemoaning the absence of boyhood playmates for the rest of his life.
This young man, you had to feel sorry for him.
One childhood experience, however, was to leave so great an impression on him that he would refer back to it throughout his life, from early newspaper interviews right up to his final public appearance when he was almost 80 years old.
Please don't be alarmed.
At the age of 5 or 6, Alfred Hitchcock was found guilty of misbehaving at home, and his father chose to reprimand his young son in a decidedly novel way by writing a note which he ordered him to deliver to the local constabulary. The bemused child duly pocketed the note and went out, crossing over the high road and through the doors of Leytonstone's police station. Having read the note, the officer on duty proceeded to lock the young boy in a cell, where he was left to contemplate his fate for what seemed like an eternity. After 5 long minutes had elapsed, the policeman returned and unlocked the cell, ushering the boy out with the grave words, "That's what we do to naughty boys." Shaking and confused, Alfred Hitchcock scampered out of the police station, never to return. The incident would ignite a lifelong terror of police officers and any kind of enforced confinement, which would ultimately have a profound impact on his adult outlook and unexpected consequences for his future career.
I think that since he mythologized it such a lot and always referred to it, it must have influenced him. Whatever really happened, he used that to tell us something about himself and his anxiety.
Oh dear, they're at it again.